we want to match the correct equation to the correct graph. Analyzing the four equations, notice only two of them are in the form of f of x equals log base a of x, which is number one and number two. Looking at our notes, when we have a function or equation in this form, if a is greater than one, the function is increasing. If a is between 0 and 1, the function is decreasing. Notice for number 1, the base is 1/2, and therefore the function is decreasing, or the graph is going downhill from left to right. For number 2, the base is 4, and therefore the function is increasing. The graph must go uphill from left to right. This indicates that the graph for number 1 must either be this graph or this graph, because these two functions are decreasing, and the graph for number 2 must be either this graph or this graph, because these are the two increasing functions. And now starting with number 1, we'll start with the equation y equals log base 1/2 of x, and use a table of values to find one or two points on the graph, and then we'll see which graph from the second column contains those points. To find the points though, we'll write the equivalent exponential equation, which is 1/2 to the power of y equals x. And now we'll make a table of values, but because we have 1/2 to the power of y, we'll select y values, not x values. Let's go ahead and use y equals 0 and y equals negative 1. When y is 0, we have 1/2 to the power of 0 equals x, and x is 1. When y is negative 1, we have 1/2 to the power of negative 1 equals x. Recall 1/2 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 2 divided by 1 to the power of positive 1, indicating x equals 2. So now we're looking for the graph of the function that is decreasing and contains these two points. We'll notice all the graphs contain the point 1, 0, the x-intercept or horizontal intercept, but only one function is decreasing and contains the point 2, -1, which is this top graph here on the right. This graph is the correct graph for the equation y equals log base 1/2 of x. Let's label this number 1. And now we'll consider number 2 and take the same approach. Number 2, we have y equals log base 4 of x. The equivalent exponential equation is 4 to the power of y equals x. And now we'll make a table of values and select y values. Let's select 0 and 1 for y. When y is 0, x is equal to 4 to the 0 or 1. When y is 1, x is 4 to the 1st or 4. We're looking for the graph that is increasing and contains these two points. The increasing functions are on the left. Only one of them contains the point 4, 1, which is this top graph. This is the correct graph for the equation y equals log base 4 of x. We label this number 2. And now let's look at equations 3 and 4. Notice equation 1 and 3 are the same, except equation 3 has this negative, and equation 4 is the same as equation number 2, again, except for the negative. Y equals negative log base 1/2 of x is the graph of y equals log base 1/2 of x reflected vertically or reflected across the x-axis. This negative would take all the points on the graph of y equals log base 1/2 of x and change the sign of all of the y-coordinates. We already know the graph of y equals log base 1/2 of x is labeled number 1. So if we reflect this graph across the x-axis, we can determine the graph of y equals negative log base 1/2 of x. Let's just reflect this one point across the x-axis, 2, -1. We can do this visually or simply change the sign of the y-coordinate, which gives us the point 2, 1. Of the two remaining graphs, only one of them contains the point 2, 1, which is this graph here in the lower left-hand corner. More specifically, hopefully we can visualize, if we reflect the graph of number 1, or y equals log base 1/2 of x across the x-axis, the piece above the x-axis would now be below the x-axis, and the piece below the x-axis, this piece here, would be above the x-axis here, which is why the graph of y equals negative log base 1/2 of x is this graph here. Of course, this leaves the last graph to be number 4, but again, let's talk about why. The graph of y equals negative log base 4 of x would be the graph of y equals log base 4 of x reflected across the x-axis, or reflected vertically, because the negative in number 4 would take all of the points on the graph of number 2 and change the sign of the y-coordinates. We know the graph of y equals log base 4 of x is this graph here, labeled number 2. If we reflect the point 4, 1 across the x-axis, it becomes the point 4, negative 1. And notice this last graph does contain the point 4, negative 1, this point here. Or more specifically, if we reflect number 2 across the x-axis, the part below the x-axis, this piece, becomes this piece of the graph above the x-axis, and this piece above the x-axis becomes this piece below the x-axis. This last graph is the correct graph for y equals negative log base 4 of x. I hope you found this helpful.